All right, so Komodo is the white pieces and Stockfish is the black pieces. So e4, e5 and f4. Here we have a king's gambit. Now Stockfish takes, best move I think, and a book move. We have a bishop c4 and knight c6. We have d4, taking some space in the center. We have queen h4, check, and king f1. It surprises me that Komodo doesn't play knight f6 earlier, such as here, if you play knight f6, you cannot prevent this move. But yeah, Komodo instead allows this queen check and then goes king f1. Wow, okay. We have d6, knight f3, now attacking the queen. We have bishop g4, pinning, so if you take the queen, your queen gets taken. Yep, but bishop b5 was played, moving a bishop twice in the opening. Isn't this supposed to be bad? Well, if Komodo plays it, I assume not. We have queen h5 attacking the bishop, and we have d5, and not only... Huh? Oh, never mind. If you take the... I thought Stockfish has blundered a piece, but the thing is, if you take the knight, then your bishop gets taken by the queen. So it doesn't quite win a piece. So bishop e2 was played instead. Now knight goes to knight c e7. We have bishop takes, now taking the pawn back, finally. And Stockfish plays f4, striking in the center. If I was Komodo in this position, I would be terrified. This looks so scary. There's so much pressure. Knight is coming in. This is hanging. The knight has a lot of pressure. It's kind of pinned, not really, but kinda. Yeah, it just looks very, very bad for whites. Although the elevation says that white is just minus 0.4, so it's probably fine with perfect play. We have c4, which is an inaccuracy. Better move would have been knight g5. We have knight f6 and knight c3. Defending, or not really, it's still not defended. But, nah, right. Stockfish just doesn't want to take that pawn. Knight g5, I assume. Is this a threat? Not really. Doesn't really do anything. But now these things see each other, so maybe we have some trades going on. Knight g6 was played, attacking the bishop. A lot of red arrows here. We have bishop back to c1. Okay, best move. Wow, that's kind of a cool move. You know, getting the bishop back to your first rank, locking this rook in. Although I think the reason for this is because Komodo sees some future of pawn storm on the queen side. We have knight e5, putting the knight on a very nice outpost square. We have bishop takes bishop, knight takes bishop, and bishop f4, bringing the bishop back. We have h6, kicking knight to e6, and yeah, the knight is very well placed. We have g5, putting the bishop away, to bishop goes to d2. We have f takes, queen e2, knight e5, and b3, which is an inaccuracy. You're supposed to take the queen, take the queen. We have queen g6, and now king g1. This rook is really miserable in this position. Bishop e7, we have h3, and now a brilliant move, rook takes e6. Why is this a brilliant? Well, I assume it is because this knight is bloody amazing here, and this rook is trash. It's kind of just trapped in here. So, yeah, getting rid of the knight is probably a good choice. And now Stockfish is going to win the pawn as well. We have rook takes, we have queen e3, attacking this pawn over here. We have knight h5, not giving a shit about it. If you take this pawn, then this fork is going to happen. We have knight e2, preventing this fork from happening. We have rook e8. This pawn is still hanging, although Komodo doesn't want it. Komodo instead plays bishop c3. Now king b8, protecting the pawn. And now king h2. Wow, what a amazingly weird move. We have g4. This just looks terrible for Komodo. Like, this is so scary. Rook g1. a6, bishop takes knight, bishop takes, like, what? This looks crushing. Yeah, I mean, Stockfish has an advantage, but I would assume it would be like a 4-point advantage, because this looks very, very dangerous. Although it's probably fine because Komodo has every single piece protecting the king over here. So king is probably decently safe. And Komodo is not up material, but has a rook for a bishop and two pawns. King back to h1 and knight f6. We have rook d1 and d5. Mm-hmm. Takes in accuracy. Bishop back to d6. Wow, okay. Rook df1. Knight takes d5, attacking the queen. Queen goes back to f2. And now rook e5. Right, so knight f4, attacking the queen and offering knight trade. Queen back. g3, sacrificing a pawn, takes. And knight takes knight. Rook takes. And rook trade offer. Takes, takes. And here, Stockfish is actually completely winning, as you can see on the valuation. We have e3, attacking the queen. Queen f3. And bishop takes pawn, sacrificing the bishop. Why? What would happen if you take? Let's just have a look. Queen here, apparently. And then here. Oh, rip rook. That's why. Okay, makes sense. So instead, this was played. And now, yeah. Here, as you can see, it goes from 1.4 advantage from Stockfish to a 4-point advantage. So, yeah. Bishop f2 was played, and this pawn is just not going to disappear. We have rook c1, queen e5, queen takes h3. And now e2, and it's going to promote there. Yeah, makes a rook. Stockfish is a boss. Takes, takes, queen there. Now, slowly but surely, Stockfish just wins the position. Pushes there, there. Check, check. Bishop takes. Yeah, no. Komodo has no pawns left. Yeah, Komodo offers a queen trade. And here, Stockfish just goes, brings the pawns up, makes a queen, makes another queen, goes with a check, and a checkmate. So, Stockfish wins the game. Shocker. Wow, so this game was way, very, very nice looking. Like, very nice looking. It was a very interesting position. So I should probably make the chess engines play more aggressive openings in the future, because it leads to cooler games. If you wonder about the accuracy, Stockfish play with an very, very high 98% accuracy, and Komodo play with 89.4. So that's pretty poor. I mean, it's not poor, but it's poor for a super engine chess thingy. So yeah, that's all for this game. Thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe if you'd like to, and peace.